Overhead squat. Overhead squat.
Overhead squat, yeah. So a bit of leg strength there. Plus, they've got it over their head. Alright, you might as well use it and stick in some overhead squat. Alright, so you've got powerful exercise requiring a fast moving exercise with a squat movement with an extra squat in essence there, right? So you're really moving the legs there. After that, you're probably going to be pretty pocket, to be honest. That's going to be quite tiring. So, because you're stretching the legs, you might end up adding another squat, maybe a back squat, or something like that. Okay? And then, basically, CrossFit, you can sit in a wad here quite nicely. At the end of that, there's a bit of a blower, like a little body weight type circuit, something like that. And actually, from an S&C point of view, having a bit of a challenge, blow out of the end is quite a good way of finishing the session. Alright. So you might have like a thing like medicine wall ball throw with, I don't know, push-ups, press-ups, that kind of thing. For your sets and reps for your snatch and overhead squat here again, you're looking at fairly low reps, alright? And because you're going to be fairly nearly stretched from that first exercise as well, you don't want to be doing too many sets. If your focus is leg stroke as well for this session, you want to make sure you've got enough volume for your back squat. Alright? So you've got to have enough sets and reps to instigate an effect by doing that exercise. So 5x5, or if you want a bit more muscle size on the guys and the other players, then you might do 4x8. Okay, it's up to you. But what you've got to work out is why you're giving them this, and you've got to justify it as a coach as well. But it's the way assessment becomes a bit of science. Alright? And then your snatch here, you said maybe we'll just keep this fairly light, 3x3, open the squat, and just do 3x2, because we're going to be pretty comfortable with the snatch. Alright? So session one, again, you know, we're looking at something that might be doing some lifting. We want to look at this from Kelly's kind of point of view here in terms of weight and periodization as well. So your snatch, this might vary over the program as well. But if you look at one big snapshot to start with, then the snatch you might be doing 5 sets of 3 at 80%. And then this is going to go up and periodize in a similar way to Kelly's program. So you're going to start to drop the sets and repetitions and start to increase the loading over a period of time. loading into the area one
is the best way to vary a programme for beginners, for complete beginners. Okay? By just adding more weight, keeping it the same, keeping it really simple. So maybe 5 sets of 3 for 6 weeks, but they're just adding more load. Okay? Keeping the sessions the same as well for a period of time so that they get used to the movements and they can practice the movement patterns. Okay? You don't want to be changing exercises week in, week out. It's a lot of programming for you to do, and it's a lot for them to learn as well. Alright. So five sets of 3-yard snatch, we might do 4 sets of 4 or clean and jerk. 75. And again, that's going to vary over our period of time. You can then add in some other resistance exercises here, typical ones that you might use with rugby or other sports, assistance exercises.
RDLs.
RDLs, everyone's got a great position.
Ready, deadlift? Session 3 then, maybe an easy session, okay, because you're going to be the screw from here on as well. Okay, so nice light, low volume, 3 sets of 3 at 80% to start. Again, this is going to start to increase as you go over time. Hang cleans, you might do 4 sets of 2, 80 to 85%. And then again, you might want to do a little light circuit here, or a wad. Or what I sometimes call them gym challenges. Can't even write now. Gym challenges, you know, so say how many sets you can do, how many pull-ups in, you know, log it, or you know, do it for a bit of fun. How many press-ups can you do them in? Some stuff like that. Okay. Any questions? So that is programming in a nutshell. A very, very fast explanation. It's not, to be honest, it's not the best way of doing it. There are other ways of doing it, but this is kind of the basics of how you would look at putting something together. Alright, 3 sessions a week. Keeping it nice and simple from a strength condition point of view, where you're hitting some other factors as well as getting into the fitness nail and lifting heavy. Okay? And as I say, that's just a snapshot. You've then got to be able to periodise that or plan then over a period what you're going to do in terms of increasing weight and getting to variation. Right? As a basic idea for variation, do any of you do right programs?
Mm-hmm.
Strength condition programs, what sort of method do you use?
You analyse a sport.
Yeah, but in terms of just sort of planning, how might you what blocks would you use for programming?
Well, that depends what programming you're using.
It does depend, but how 4 to 6 weeks. And then you want to have some variation across that block as well, right? You don't necessarily want to just be going that week's there, that week's there, that week's there, getting harder and harder and harder, keep going up and you just fall apart, okay? 6 weeks is too long to keep doing that. You could do that in 4 weeks, but at the end of that block, you need a deload week when you take the weight off and you recover. The same as this. You need to deload week. Alright? So as a rule of thumb, make sure that there's some variation across weeks over your block that you're working with. Alright, and how might you work out how to get some variation? If you use the same program like this, how do you vary it across a 4 week block like that? So, no, we're going to keep the sessions the same. We're going to keep sets of reps the same.
Move the weights, week 1, 2, 3 up, and then you drop.
Yeah.
On week 4 down.
So, you change the loading, yeah? You keep the loading really simple. So, this is a light week, this is a medium week, this is a heavy week. Okay? So, here, we're working with 80%, alright? But if we're 75 to 80%, but if we're working with a beginner, that's 70%, or 75% isn't going to be the same. 2 or 3 weeks down the line, okay? You're going to be working at a lighter load if you're using the same load. So you've got to keep pushing it up and up and up, okay? So that's a load that's really easy to vary over a block. You get that natural variation like that if you just increase the weights each week.
Guys, we need that confusing here for 85% in one session. What do you think, for example, if you have a 100 kilogram snatch? Yeah. Can I use the top? Mm-hmm. If you have a 100 kilogram snatch with your 100%, and you're going to the week 7 in 90%, how you train with 20 kilograms, 5. 40 kilograms, I said, I'm not the right number again. 4. 50 kilograms, 3. 60 kilograms, 3. 70 kilograms, 3. 80 kilograms, 2. 90 kilograms, you have a single, isn't it? 1 or 2, but nice. So you do it 1 and 3 times. And you go back to recovery, 75 kilograms, 3, and you finish. So you should take 20 minutes, 25 minutes, half an hour. That's good work for you. Your testosterone level go higher if you do it more than 20 minutes. It just goes straight away. 90 kilograms, 50, 70 single, 80, you finished. So you need to work out. You have to work out slowly. Increase your hormones.
So sorry, what Kaz is saying is that if you're lifting 85%, you don't just go straight up to 85% on the bar and start lifting that. You can warm up, build up, and push the weight slowly. Yeah?
We go heavy, go recover them. You go 10 kilograms, 20 kilograms less, do 3, you go home. Do you think if you keep them at group to be the program for basketball, volleyball,
so that's set up more for if you're looking for your one full yeah. competition as a weightlifter for your one maximum lift.
This is your section like 7 or 8 weeks. So if you go the last week, it becomes different. But you have to say if you need to go to, for example, section week 10, you are in 95 kilograms, yeah? So it's different, you're going like 23, 43, 52, 62, 72, 80 single, 90 single twice, Can you go 95 single twice? Altogether, that's 3, 6, 8, 10, 12. 14, 15, 17. Should be 17 or 18 altogether. But when you are in the to build up, you get better, be stronger. You go, it's not 100, it's 150 repetitions. But the last lift is important because you go heavy. You spend less time and likely it's a warm-up. But don't use the percentage of 5 times 5, then go 20 kilograms. You have no energy there. But this is different. This competition is for like 2 weeks before competition. Before. And this is like 5 weeks before. So you have more time here to recover.
So what is on your program?
Is not 70%.
Yeah, so what does that mean? Why does it not count if it's not above 70%?
Because you're not challenging a load that you're programmed for.
Yeah, so what are you programmed for?
Well, lifting 70%.
No, not yet. No. What does lifting 70%, sorry, bad question. What is lifting 70% or more do?
It increases power and speed.
It increases your power, your strength, and your speed. Okay? If you don't lift above 70%, you're not going to get as big a gain in terms of strength and speed. Okay? So, in essence, don't count that because that's a warm up. Alright? That is going to be quite tiring for somebody that's new. You do all that and then try and stress them there. Okay? Which is why I'm trying to put the lift into as few as possible when you're working with beginners. So, you've got to be lifting above 70% to actually get some serious gains in strength and speed and power.
When I was training for championship in a DVD camp for 3 months, no family, no ex-soldier, 3 months training. And we have to book, we have to record what they will be lifting every day. So the tonnage, you have to add everything after they finish. We finished, you have to add how many kilograms I need one day. Sometimes I had like 19 tonnage in one day. 19,000 kilograms in one day. So can you keep a record that we can see in after 4 or 5 months time how much you get stronger by record the tonnage in your sessions. Just see like a picture. You can load more and more. You can record it.